And welcome to 8 Out of 10 Cats Does Countdown Best Bits, a show about letters, numbers, conundrums and all the best bits from the last series. Trust me, it's going to be a very exciting 3.5 minutes. Let's get started. So, let's meet tonight's players. First up, it's Richard Iowati. Richard Iowati, he's as awkward as going to kiss your nan goodbye and her slipping you the tongue. And Richard's teammate, Aisling B. Aisling B is from Ireland, but we don't like stereotypes on this show. So I've been through the script and removed all references to Guinness, four-leaf clovers and leprechauns. In fact, I went through it twice. To be sure, to be sure. Joe is bisexual, or to put it in countdown terms, he likes two from the top and one from the bottom.
Do you know what? He's not wrong.
John says he only gets 4 hours of sleep a night. No fucking shit, John. Jessica wrote and starred in the sitcom Drifters. If you've never seen Drifters, I can't help you, because I've never seen Drifters.
You're missing out, Jimmy. You're missing out.
Four series.
Yeah.
Yeah, I thought I'd not watch three series, but it turns out it's four. Rachel's been on Countdown for almost 10 years and is now in her 30s. On a completely unrelated note, if you're young, hot and good at maths, Channel 4 would like to hear from you.
I shall send in my application.
Ever since I've known Johnny, he's been hungry for success. Sorry, pasties. Success he can take or leave, unless success comes with chips.
You're going to just sit there and take that?
I've actually dropped 2.5 stone because I've cut out carbs.
I've got something for you later on. I've got a surprise for you later on that will make up for all of this, Johnny.
You're going to be really?
Made up. Yeah.
What? Is it like people I love coming back from the dead? It's not, Jimmy. Don't waste your time.
OK, Miles, do you think you'll make a good team this evening?
We might do. We've been a team many times, I think, now. We've not been a very successful team, but we get on. Well, I'm like his favourite uncle, and he's a sort of nephew that I'm slightly worried about, but I know if I keep an eye on him, things will be all right.
You know, you're 20 years younger than him. I'm fascinated by you. You're such an old man.
This is just... I just don't...
Yes, exactly, an old man answer. Well, I just... That couldn't have been any better delivered if you had a sherry and a pipe.
I just sort of be who I am, I suppose. I don't sort of hide myself behind sort of hair dye and expensive suits.
They're not expensive.
Sean, if you could bring something extinct back to life, what would it be?
Well, glad you asked me, Jimmy. First off, I thought, oh, I'd like to do Jurassic Park, but make it safe. I'd take all their teeth and nails out. But then I had a brilliant idea. If I could reanimate something, I'd reanimate all the leaders of the Nazi party, all the top Nazis.
Just leave it there. Sean Lock, everyone. Sean Lock, everyone, that's the end of his career. No Sheen.
No.
No Sheen. Would you say you have a broad vocabulary, No Sheen?
You can't leave it there.
We can't, it's just the end of Sean's career, it doesn't matter. He's had a wonderful career, years in the business, and then he brought back the Nazis. Roisin, would you say you've got a broad vocabulary?
I like put them all on an island.
Sorry, who?
Put all the Nazis, the top Nazis, put them on an island and then film it.
Oh.
And people would love that, wouldn't it? And you go like, oh, Goebbels hasn't caught any fish today. Hitler's very hungry.
Oh, my God! Yeah.
If anything, it got worse after I stopped. so much worse. Now, girls, you said, want to send him fishing on a desert island. I want to take the Nazis, I want to reanimate them and put them in paradise. It's what they deserve.
No, they don't get any supplies. They got to fend for themselves.
Has this show got a name?
Yeah, Nazi Island.
Roisin.
Yes, Jimmy.
You're a member, a leading member of the English Defence League. Why did you...
It's very easy to make judgments about bringing all the top Nazis. And suggesting that it was done in some obscene political way. It's very easy and judgmental. And I expect better from you, Jimmy.
Would they have currency on the island?
No, they just have to thrive by their cunning, their natural cunning and skills.
They are cunning. Say what you want about them, they are cunny fuckers.
Oh, I'm so glad I brought up.
Can you imagine?
What are you doing there?
Hitler trying to get up a coconut tree to get a coconut.
Do you remember that time Sean mimed Hitler shimmying up a coconut tree? Do you remember that time? Do you remember on television where Sean mimed shimmying up, you know, Hitler? Lou, have you got a mascot?
Well, I've got this hat I've got made called Dick Inspector. Because I don't think there's enough sort of female sexual predators. So I'm trying to bring it back for you sort of peeping toms and stuff from a female perspective.
Finally, something I can get behind.
Thank you. And I've also got a book that I'm bringing out called Get in the Van and Other Chat-Up Lines. Which I'm writing. So I bought some chat-up lines for everybody today.
Oh, lovely. OK, what have you got?
Rachel, your eyes are like a deep blue swimming pool. I really want to touch your bottom. Susie, your name's Susie. Yeah? But is your middle name Fizzwiz? Because I really want you to explode in my mouth. Jimmy Carr.
Yeah.
Your name is Jimmy Carr, yeah? That's funny, because I like my men how I like my cars. Imported from China and locked in the garage.
Yes, sure. Sean, have you got a mascot?
Yeah, I do, yeah. You know, like Iceland does their party food range?
Oh, lovely, yeah.
So I brought out a range of my party food. And I'd like to start off with this one. Bun mushrooms. Right? Bun mushrooms wrapped in anchovies. And that's called prisoners in blankets. John would like this.
I'd love to, but I don't eat shit.
Honestly, they
don't
are
do it.
An absolute sensation.
Oh, no.
Rachel, you're usually game for these things.
I usually am, but I've gone vegan.
Have you?
In the last 5 minutes.
Sorry.
This is one of my favourites.
This is
liver with a candy floss. And that's a pervert in playground. And that. Oh, well, you know when you've had a treat. Here goes another one here. This is a mussel on a little cocktail sausage. And that's called pigeons on benches.
What is that one again?
It's a mussel and a little cocktail sausage. Oh. You should try some of these, Jimmy. I'm going to do you a little plate. We've got some other ones here. We've got widows on bikes. That's Brussels sprout with the poor scratching in between.
Nothing vegetarian then so far.
Well, that is. Oh, it's pork scratching. Come on. And I think, Jimmy, you'll appreciate this one most of all. This is it's a chip marinated in whiskey for 2 days, right, then lightly roasted in the oven and sprinkled with icing sugar. This is called Jocks on Smack.
OK, let's count down, everyone. Time for the first game. Alan and Harry, you get the first pick of the letters.
What do we want? Vowel?
Yeah. Good start. Go for it, love.
Then what do you think?
Alan, you've got one bit of hair. Well, yeah. Well, you've got one bit of hair that's kind of... that's. I mean, it looks great. I don't know whether that's the... whether it's all meant to be doing that.
What? No, you're freaking me out now. What's wrong?
I don't know. Is there what,
it's
is
going it... quite up. Oh,
well, there's one bit going up.
Oh, my God. Thank God. Thank God. Consonant, please.
Zed.
Now we need to... we've got another problem. Well, you look like the action man I had with a beard. It's all... did you go into a barber's and gone, everything on my head the same length?
What for Greg Bowery?
We've got an O and a Z. It's a good start. You're doing very well.
Oz, write that down. three vowels. Come on, let's get going. Three vowels.
E-I-E.
Another consonant. All consonants!
N. Is that too many?
S? No, I think that's very good.
Yeah, good girl. See. Good
okay.
girl.
And for the first time today, here's the countdown clock. We made mini versions of everyone. Sean, the years have not been kind. I mean, you were a very handsome young man.
Which one are you talking about? Have you started drinking yet?
I love her.
I mean, he's look at the swag as well. The only slight criticism I've got is he's got real teeth.
Who's older, your actual teeth or the little boy?
How old are you? Seven. Same age. It's the Cats Does Countdown clones, everyone. Give them a round of applause. Thank you very much. Hi there. Thanks very much, everyone.
Like when you see the first Harry Potter and the last one.
Okay. Alan, how many you got?
Seven.
You've got seven?
Yeah, I've got seven.
Oh, well, we'll wait and see. Harriet, how many have you got?
I've got five.
Sean, how many have you got?
Six.
Six. And Phil?
Seven.
Well, let's, Harriet, let's hear your five.
I've got onesie. Susie, is that a word? It's like a, yeah, you know
it's
what it is.
It's a six-letter word is what it is.
But you said five. Can I just say, she's written scones, but with a Z at the end.
OK, what about onesie? Onesie?
Onesie. Onesie's
good.
O-N-E-S-I-E, right?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Excellent word.
Sean, what's your six?
Nieces.
Ooh, that's good.
Nieces.
As in, I've been having a bit of trouble with my nieces. Can you get these bloody nieces off my lawn? I want to take a contract out on these nieces. Do you kill nieces?
Phil, you're seven.
My seven is notices. Oh. As in, notices have been taken out against Sean for how he treats his nieces.
Alan, for 7 points.
I've got notices too.
7 points to both teams. OK, over in Dictionary Corner, we've got lifestyle gurus Lemily and Cassandra, a.k.a. Mum's the Word. Hello. Ladies, it's very nice to have you on the show. Could you tell us a little bit about yourselves?
Oh, please. Oh, can we stand up for this? I'd like to get a little bit of a sense of the room.
Space. Yeah.
Hello. Hello, everyone at the back. Hello. Oh, darling, sorry. You're a little bit tucked up there, aren't you? Yeah.
You're a little bit tucked up.
Oh, God, so I'm old. I am. Well, that's what happens when you have kids. You get big.
You do.
You get very big. Yeah.
It doesn't really make much difference to me because I've had six, but I was born big. When I came out, it was basically just two big lips and a pair of legs.
Oh, OK. Anyway, we are Lem.
Emily and Cassandra, aka Mum's the Word, lifestyle gurus, columnists, advisors. But first and foremost, we're just a couple of mums. I was expecting a round of applause for that, the most important job in the world.
Thank you. The most important job. Thank you. We're mums.
It's exciting being here, Jimmy. It is exciting. But I wouldn't let my kids watch this show.
Sorry, Sean.
I wouldn't let my kids watch this. Stern
Sorry.
Face.
Sorry, Sarah.
Jimmy
Sorry,
looks like the ghost of an Edwardian child.
It's scary.
John's gender is so ambiguous.
It's confusing.
It is.
Do you know what? Thank God for Susie and Rachel.
Thank God.
Thank God. Two women looking absolutely stunning, saying not very much, one shoved under a desk, one in the corner, where they belong.
Thank you. Thank you.
Mum's the word, Mum's the word.
And here is your teaser. The words are cat minge. The clue is both attractive and repulsive. That's cat minge, both attractive and repulsive. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser. The words were cat minge. The clue was both attractive and repulsive. It was, of course, magnetic. OK, they've been playing in teams so far, but this game is just for Joe and Sean. Sean, your turn to choose the letters.
Can I have a selection, please?
S-I...
Oh.
Q... Get rid of that.
Lovely six.
U-S... O.
This is going really down, fast. Slow
really
down.
Fast.
V. E. R.
Okay, and your time starts now. Catherine Ryan.
You see that? Gosh. I love that.
I've done a Sean Locke. It's quite a lot of work on the forehead there.
Oh.
I've done a Joe.
Oh, hold on.
And I've done one of John as well. Rachel, I've done one for you as well.
Wow.
And for Dictionary Corner, that's John and Susie there.
What on earth is that? Fat top lip.
John, are you happy with yours?
Well, it's piss take, isn't it? Get a love handles.
John, are you happy with yours?
Yeah, just as eager as me. I got my three testicles right.
This is difficult for me because in college, and by college I mean Hooters, I was... I was targeted by an inflatophiliac who tricked me into putting, like, clear bags down my, like, different... I can't even talk about it. He challenged me to put... He said if you put clear bags down your pantyhose and then, like, inflate them somehow, if you can figure that out, how to do it, and take photos and email them to me, then I'll give you $300. Okay, I'm like... I thought it was smart because I put these like clear plastic bags. I went down to the petrol station. I used like fake pump and I like pumped them up so I had these huge legs. And then I just did it for like weeks because he kept challenging me like hard to challenge. And then those pictures were on a website for people who get off on
on balloons, and he still follows my, like, career, and he still reaches out every once in a while, and this is gonna be bad.
And if anyone's interested, $300.
Did you get the money?
No.
OK, back to the game. Sean, what have you got?
I think I've got an 8.
Joe, what have you got?
6.
What is your 6?
Tosser.
Tosser. Susie.
Can I have yes. Tosser?
You can, yes. British vulgar slang. A person who masturbates, brackets, used as a general term of abuse.
Sean, you're 8.
Vitreous.
Vitreous for 8. Come on, round of applause for Vitreous. 8 points for Sean. Right, now time for Alan and Miles to go head-to-head. Alan, your turn to pick the numbers.
OK, I'll have 2 big ones and 4 little ones, please.
2 large, 4 Lovely. Little. Coming up. And they are 10, 8, 7, 2, 50 and 75.
75, 8.
And the target, 684.
OK, and your time starts
That's good.
Now. Okay, so the target was 684. Miles, how did you do it?
I did 8 times 75.
600.
And then I did 10 plus 7 times 2 is 34.
Yeah.
Add that on and then add 50.
Yeah.
Some of those. 10 points to Miles.
But the randomizer genuinely random.
Yeah.
Is it though?
Press the randomizer again. Let's see how random it is. I think it's going to be 2, 2, 3 is the next one up.
It'd be a good thing to lose a lot of money on, wouldn't it?
Do you want to play Who's Closest?
Yeah, let's play Who's Closest.
Right.
Why
are
we
going to
play this game?
We've got 10er.
3 M&Ms I'm putting in.
I'll have you 2 Alan Carr mugs.
We've invented a new round. 134. I'm going for 134.
I'm going between 500 and 520.
Oh, you're not saying an exact number?
Oh, it's got to be the exact number, Sean.
All right, 526.
Yeah, yeah.
Between 500 and 520, and the exact number you went for was 526. How shut a maths are we as a group?
I'm going for 478.
824.
Miles? Miles, what you got?
I'm going for 673.
OK. Press the button.
Oh. Man, if it's spot on.
Don't mess with a machine! Don't mess with a machine! Don't mess with a game countdown. I'm sorry for what we did. Press it again, press it again, press it again!
I mean, that's scary shit. Listen, if we get that scary shit, why don't we just pick the numbers with a Ouija board?
I was the closest
you
to
You owe Miles a tenner.
Yeah, never mind your fear of the occult. I'm a... What's it?
Jimmy, sorry, but can we have it now? Because we know what you're like.
Time now to go across the dictionary corner. Spencer, what have you got for us?
Well, I'm 42 and I'm starting to get a bit of that. Mm. So I can't be bothered to run because it's boring. So what I did, I bought one of them. Vibration plate. Yeah? And what you do is you stand on it, you turn it on like that, press play, and it does that. But what I found is if you stand to one side, it does that. And that's on setting number 1. Goes up to 99. And that's 44. There's 2 people now just looking directly into my eyes. And that's 69.
Ha 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 ha
36. And that's 99. I can't use it indoors, you've got dodgy floorboards. All the stuff falls off the bloody shelves. After about 3 minutes, you really need a wee. I'm starting to worry what it's doing to my brain. I need to eat off now because I need to poo.
And here is your teaser. The words are less limp. The clue is Susie won't be happy. That's less limp. Susie won't be happy. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the tease, the words were less limp. The clue was Susie won't be happy. It was, of course, misspell. Susie, I hear you might be doing a tour this year. What is the Susie Dent tour? What will it involve?
Well, Susie Dent tour is like a Jimmy Carr tour, but it's about £20 cheaper.
Go on, so you're on tour. Go on, tell me.
Well, basically, I just talk for an hour and then I will answer people's queries.
So what's the most common question you get asked, then?
Don't know if this, I have been asked this twice this year already, which is quite a common question, and that is, one of them was from quite an elderly lady, and she said, what does the G stand for in G-spot?
What does it stand for?
It stands for a guy called Hingis Grafenberg, who was the lucky guy who found it.
It's interesting, because do you know...
Because you've written a book about this,
yeah,
haven't you?
Yeah, so there's a woman called Beverly Whipple who actually discovered it and didn't want it named after her. It was going to be called Whipple's Tickle, and she didn't want her name used on it. And there's no part of the vagina that's named after a person that isn't named after a man.
Yeah.
Whipple's a much better name.
Yeah.
I've got another good vagina fact.
Yeah. This show just got excellent.
Apparently, the G-spot isn't actually a real thing, but the clitoris is, like, 10 centimetres long.
Wow. OK.
And isn't it true it was originally called the Clitor Chris?
After the guy that found it.
The guy called Chris who found it first.
I was actually in lower six with him. Yeah, he's a good bloke. OK, and in charge of the numbers, it's Rachel Riley. Rachel's clitoris is 10 centimetres long. Alan, have you got a mascot?
It's a plea, really. To the producer, I don't know if you know, there's a new Elton John biopic coming out called Rocket Man, yeah. Ooh. Now, I'm not going to lie, I am made for that part, innit? I look like Elton John, don't I? I have the same body shape as Elton John. And as Dame Judi Dench told me one day, it's not who you know, it's who you blow in Hollywood. And so this is my plea. I want to be the Elton John in the new, in the biopic. Here, look at this. Don't look like me. Wait there.
Am I on a team with him now? Really good.
Saturday. And also, what I've done is we actually used a 3D state-of-the-art printer to make Elton's actual hands. A 3D state-of-the-art printer and two packs of Richmond sausages.
Oh, Nikita, you would never know.
Have you even got his temperance? Say something to me, Harriet.
Fuck
off, you vile pig!
Ken, have you got your keyboard?
Yeah.
Could we just test the keyboard out?
Can because... in the wind.
Yeah, can in the wind.
There you go. Yeah, just hear this.
Oh.
It's no sacrifice.
I feel like we're in an old people's home.
John, have you got a mascot?
It's not a mascot, it's a chance. We're on telly.
Right.
I think it's a chance to use your voice to do some good, and I want to raise an issue in the world, and it's the plight of the skink.
The what?
The skink. If it's a sort of lizard-like creature, close to my own heart. Every 30 seconds, Jimmy, on this planet, we lose a species of skink. Every time you hit that buzzer tonight, a species of skink will be eradicated from the face of the earth. Don't touch it now. Don't touch it now. And you find the skink that means the most to you. This fella is the yellow-bellied pygmy skink. Just speaks to me. It's cold-blooded, obviously, much like myself. Keeps its nest very tidy, the yellow-bellied pygmy skink. Its penis is bigger than its brain. One of the features of the skink, when scared, the skink detaches its tail, this is true, and the tail carries on wriggling, so the predator thinks it's getting the skink. This is Colin. You can sponsor Scolin. You can... fucking pressure on this skink bit now. It's just a bit of fun. You can sponsor Scolin here. Oh, for hard to say.
You're getting quite emotional about this.
Yeah, you can sponsor Nigel. So we're trying to breed the skinks in captivity that they can then be released back into the wild. And as a special treat tonight, we have the last remaining yellow-bellied pygmy skink in captivity. Now, obviously, they frighten very easily. And the tail does come off if frightened, so he's undercover. I think Fabio's going to bring him out. So you can just have a little look. You can stroke the skink if you're very nice to him. Hello there. You have to be very quiet. Now, the other interesting thing... Let me talk to you about the green-crested Abigail skink.
John Richardson, everyone, and the skink.
OK, they've been playing in teams so far, but this game is just for Alan and Johnny. So, Alan, your turn to choose the letters and also to win.
Yes. Yeah, I'll have... what should I have?
Shall I just start putting some up and...
Yeah, mix them up. Go, yeah, knock yourself out, lad.
L. E. T. A. Y. O. M. E. And W.
Lovely.
OK, and your time starts now. Ooh. I mean, this looks fucking delicious. I didn't have, I only had 30 seconds, but I think it's a pretty good likeness.
Oh, God! He's back! I always knew you had feelings for me, but why?
I thought you might want a snack. Do you want a snack?
Is it really solid chocolate?
Yeah.
And it's my head?
That sounds nice, doesn't it?
Well, Alan, if I bite into the back of the head, maybe I can figure out what I'm thinking.
Oh, my God, that's such a good idea. Is it like a Kinder? Is there a surprise inside and a toy?
Yeah, yeah. Regret. Do you want to eat it as well? Why don't all of us eat my head?
Could I taste a bit? Is it the ear?
Yeah, you can
taste
the ear, yeah.
A bit.
Well, why are you doing that? Taste mine.
Oh.
Come on, Jimmy.
Oh.
I know you're married.
Jimmy, it's Alan.
Alan,
stop. It's Alan, dear. It's Alan. I've come to see you today. It's Alan.
Alan, lick my neck and tell me the difference.
Oh, okay. Oh, you taste good.
Don't I? Now, come on. I got my revenge. I've not washed for 9 days. Come here, you.
Let's get back to the game. Alan, how many did you get?
I got five.
Five, OK. Johnny, how many did you get?
Oh, shut up, Jimmy. Busy. I'm eating my own head. Oh, Johnny, I've just presented yourself in chocolate. How many letters did you get? I can't give a shit.
Before we go on, it's time to give our teams the chance to win some bonus points. Of course, as is tradition, when we've got John Cooper Clarke on the show, we have a poetry competition. So I've asked all the players to write a poem. OK, John, you're going to be judging these poems. Well, Catherine, you're to go first. Take it away.
My poem is about being single.
OK.
I really love the lonely life. My house is always spotless. I do know married women, though. I would describe most as a hot mess. Will I stay this way forever? The trouble with men is they're dicks. I won't deny there's one thing about them that I can't resist. They're dicks.
OK, John, you're next. Take it away.
This is called My Daughter's Laugh. My daughter's laugh is a wonderful sound. It pricks the ears of all around. It's the sound that kickstarts my everyday, my music, my bird song, my firework display. Stay young, stay happy, just giggle and titter. But just at the moment, Daddy's trying to watch the darts, and it is the final, to be fair, so could you fucking tone it down a bit, please?
John Cooper Clarke, what do you make of that poem?
Fabulous. They're all really, really quite alarmingly and worryingly good.
Well, let's have a change of gears now. Joe. Joe, what is your poem about?
My poem's about something very important to me. It's about how come it's OK to name you Willy, but it's not OK to name the fellas Willy next to you at the urinals. So my poem's called Hanging About in a Train Station Toilet Naming People's Penises. Hello, commuter, on your way to work. I'm going to call yours Captain Birdseye. Because it looks like it's wearing a polar neck and winking at me. You're welcome. I just named your penis. Hello, train driver who just nipped in for a piss. I'm going to call yours Mrs. Fernsby. My old geography teacher. Because you're small and wrinkly and have a birthmark down the side of your shaft. You're welcome. I just named your penis. Hello, please. Hello,
please. Please stop.
Hello. Hello, police officer. Police officer who's just been sent to the toilets because they've had reports of someone naming people. You can't arrest me for naming strangers cocks. Oh, you can. I didn't know that. Oh, great. Now I'm electronically tagged again.
Thank you.
think I just came fourth.
And here is your final teaser. The words are tit cakes, and the clue is, now that's just bad taste. That's tit cakes, now that's just bad taste. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the tease. The words were tit cakes. The clue was, now that's just in bad taste. It was, of course, tackiest. OK, on to another letters game, and it's time to ramp up the tension. It's time for the tension round. In this game, we're playing for double points, so the pressure's on. OK, Richard and Aisling, go ahead and pick the letters.
OK, I'm going to drop a vowel on me, Rachel.
Dropping A.
Yeah.
E.
Consonant.
D. Mm-hmm.
Vowel and vowel, please.
O. Did you want two?
OK.
A.
A.
Two consonants.
G. N.
And then, let's say it at the same time. We would like a...
Vowel. I. This is looking good.
Then we'd also like a consonant. Yep. Yeah.
And then just end it now. In some way. Vowels.
A.
Okay, for double points, your time starts now. Super smooth under tension there, Aisling. Really, really style that one out. Well done.
Oh, God, I'm so close to shitting myself.
You've got my nerves.
Joe, how many?
A risky eight.
Very risky, I would say.
Yeah.
Sean?
Five.
Five, OK. Aisling, how many?
Oh, wow.
I've got eight.
Eight, OK. Richard?
I'll go for the five.
OK, all right, what's your five?
Podge.
Podge. Nice word, podge. OK. Sean, your five?
Doing.
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 Either is fine.
Joe, you're risky. Probably not a word. Eight.
Pedoing.
You're not going to believe this.
Aisling, have you got the same word?
I also got pedoing.
Do you want me to use it in a sentence?
OK, David, what's your four?
I got this.
What?
I got this.
Well, tell us
only
what
got
is.
This. This what? Is what I got.
Well, you could just read out what you got.
This is all that I got. I only got this.
Sean.
Gassy.
How are you spelling gassy?
G-A-S-I. As in, oh, this beer's a bit gassy.
Not with that spelling.
Kathy, you're five.
Coats.
Coats.
Yeah.
Yeah, inarguable.
Yeah, very good.
Coats.
Very Christmassy as well.
Coats?
Well, a bit Christmassy.
Well, go and get your coats. I want you to fuck off.
OK, so Sean and Richard have 32, John and Jessica have 43. OK, fingers on buzzers, it's time for today's conundrum that doesn't matter.
I was born ready for that.
If you're in a hurry, John and Jessica have won. You can go now. Not you. Time for today's conundrum. Your time starts now.
Oh.
Sean.
Submarine.
Well, let's have a look and see if you're right.
Yeah.
Sean Lott gets the Countdown Conundrum.
Did you not direct a film called Submarine?
No, I rinsed my bum.
If you'd have got a two in that numbers game, you'd have won.
Yeah. Delightful news for someone who cares.
It would have been nice to win, though, wouldn't it?
Really?
Yeah. Deep down, you're really hurt. And you can't show it.
No, deep down, I've realised that I should have spent the evening with my family. The message... the message of click.
So, the final scores are Sean and Richard have 42 points, but tonight's winners, with 43 points, John and Jessica! Congratulations, you're now the proud owner of this, the Countdown Bathrobe! Thanks to all our panellists, our wonderful studio audience, and to all of you watching at home. That's it from us. Good night!
Used to be keys in a bowl, wife swapping. Now 1.5 million Brits are at it in special clubs. The World of Swingers, Monday at 10. But next tonight, really rude, but you're going to love it. Will, Jay, Neil and Simon are back with Adventures Down Under. It's the In-Betweeners 2.